En el episodio de hoy vamos a examinar 7 de las persecuciones policiales más locas captadas en vídeo. A veces ni siquiera la policía tiene el poder de fuego necesario para llevar a los criminales ante la justicia y tiene que improvisar. Abróchate el cinturón y vamos, ¿cómo se desarrollaron estas situaciones salvajes? Skirvin. El 8 de enero de 2024, en el condado de Montgomery, Ohio, un hombre llevó a los agentes del orden a una persecución a alta velocidad después de que supuestamente atropellara a una mujer de 35 años que lo visitó en su casa. Dentro de los primeros 3 minutos de la persecución, todos los oficiales que respondieron se dieron cuenta de que James tenía un arma con él en el asiento delantero. Era necesaria toda precaución y esta no era una búsqueda estándar. Mientras el humo seguía saliendo de la camioneta de James y parecía que se había quedado sin opciones, hizo lo impensable y viró hacia los vehículos policiales. Más de una docena de agentes se acercaron al lugar del accidente, dispuestos a acabar con cualquier amenaza existente en un abrir y cerrar de ojos. James Skirvin fue acusado de delito grave de agresión con un arma mortal y violencia doméstica. Nuestro cuarto caso nos lleva a Nueva Jersey, donde un hombre decide hacer un gran alboroto con una retroexcavadora. Joshua González. El 18 de diciembre de 2021, en Vineland, Nueva Jersey, los agentes acudieron a West Park Drive después de recibir un informe de un hombre que estaba destruyendo la propiedad con una retroexcavadora. Cuando llegaron, vieron inmediatamente al sospechoso, quien luego fue identificado como Joshua González, de 20 años. Los agentes intentaron detener a González mientras dañaba varias viviendas, 3 coches de policía, una ambulancia y un vehículo civil ocupado. Esto tenía todas las señales de que iba a terminar mal.
Officer in 6, negative, it's my vehicle. 829 and 826 have been totaled.
Can you call chief of police? Copy.
Come on.
Hey, I'm kind of blind here. Let me know where you're going. Right behind you. He's going south.
Jesus
Christ. Two police cars completely destroyed.
Are you all right?
No, I'm in shock.
All right, we're heading down.
All right, going to work.
All
right, come back. To
come on. We're going to have you sit down, okay?
At this point, this is a pursuit. We are in pursuit of this.
I'm going to...
Hey, they're screaming. Louis, you gotta get up here.
Produjo el peor de los resultados. Un oficial disparó su arma contra González y sus disparos dieron en el blanco. El juego de 30 minutos que González jugó con los oficiales le costó la vida luego de que los paramédicos lo declararan sin vida en el lugar de los hechos, menos de 20 minutos después.
Handcuff, hold up. What is that?
CPR.
CPR. CPR. CPR.
Un gran jurado determinó que el tiroteo era justificado y no se presentaron cargos contra el oficial. En California, una mujer con un camión de trabajo robado llevó a las autoridades a una persecución a alta velocidad hasta un tenso enfrentamiento en un restaurante Denny's. Nick Weisgreen. El 2 de octubre de 2023, agentes de Corona, California, intentaron detener un vehículo que el propietario denunció como robado. El camión de trabajo fue presuntamente robado por Nick Weisgreen, de 26 años, y cuando los agentes lo localizaron, ella no tenía intención de entregarse y los condujo a una larga persecución.
The Anaheim PD helicopter, as well as the California Highway Patrol helicopter, who is tracking the progress of this pursuit as well. Anaheim PD down low. California Highway Patrol way up high above Air 7 and all eyes on that work truck. A stolen work truck with at least a driver in the front there. Unclear whether there's anybody else inside this stolen vehicle. But the driving fairly composed here, stopping for red lights and then slowing down. Now going right through that red light there at Chandler Street. Continuing now in the westbound direction at a slow pace here. It's pretty much... a bona fide slow speed chase at this point, doing about 40 miles per hour, maybe pushing a little higher now. You can see three units behind him, three Le Havre PD units who have maintained visual of this pursuit throughout. And now they are continuing here without any further help here. But again, they have come all the way from Le Havre to try and nail this vehicle down and get him off the road. In the meantime, we are unclear whether it's a male or a female, but from a glimpse we saw just a moment ago through the driver's side window, it almost appeared to be a female driver, although we cannot yet confirm that. Still, though, heading westbound on Chandler Street.
El conductor pronto tomó una decisión sorprendente y lo que era solo una persecución a alta velocidad se convirtió en algo completamente distinto.
Coming to a stop at the green light at the entrance strip. Look at that, pulling into reverse, reversing into that La Habra PD unit, that primary unit standing still as that work truck rams into the hood of that SUV. Look at this, ramming in again in reverse. That work truck now pulling it into reverse, ramming into the front of that PD unit for no apparent reason here, but the charges have just been amped up dramatically here as he pulls into an industrial area. And look at this wild pit there, full speed into the front of the work truck, boxing him in here, and now they will be forced to use force if this driver does anything threatening whatsoever. Look at this, backing up into those black and whites. He's backing up and shoving those units out of the way, desperate to get away. Officers with their guns drawn, and the canine unit now, look at this, over the tree, through the trees, and trying to get away. He's through private property, running through a fence here. He's trying to ram through a fence.
Cuando parecía que no podía volverse más loco, se volvió mucho más loco. Después de que la mujer escapó de lo que parecía un escenario ineludible, decidió salir del vehículo y jugar en el tráfico antes de entrar a un restaurante cercano. Los agentes que la perseguían entraron al edificio tras de ella.
Be calling for backup here, and now California Highway Patrol may very well be getting involved sooner rather than later. Look at this. These vehicles are going to, look at that. The primary unit ramming full speed again. That vehicle is now disabled. The primary unit has now completely disabled that work truck, taking the fence with him and now getting on to the freeway, I think. He just got onto the freeway. He's going the wrong way on the freeway. He's going the wrong way on the 91. He's going eastbound on the westbound side of the 91 freeway. A stolen work truck ramming into police officers, refusing to pull over after what was a relatively tame pursuit, has now gone completely off the rails here as we now go eastbound on the 91 freeway with debris being dragged along the freeway, that work truck ramming into three separate La Habra PD units, those officers jumping out of their vehicle with their guns drawn, and then ramming full speed into this work truck, and now this work truck appears to be having mobility issues. Now, as he faces oncoming traffic, he's come to a standstill. As he faces oncoming traffic on the westbound side of the 91 freeway, he went full bumper cars with those La Habra PD units and then rammed over a fence, took out a tree, and it looks like that front left wheel might be in trouble there. I can't tell. I can't tell whether that is it just my view here or if that the whole front might be crooked. That front axle looks a little bit messed up, but now look at this. Look at the agitated driver behind the wheel here. This driver creating lots of havoc now, and now there's going to be a major confrontation as soon as California Highway Patrol gets into position here. Look at that. It's a female driver. A female driver jumping out of the vehicle, running into across lanes. Look at this. Oh my goodness. The female driver running across the 91 freeway. Those drivers don't see her. She is not well. She's not well. She's not well. And she is now running for it, crossing all lanes of the 91 freeway. Now using the shoulder. You see the night sun up above there by the California Highway Patrol. This woman continuing the run of her life as she has now made it to the other side of the freeway looking for a hiding spot at a Denny's. She's at a Denny's parking lot on the other side of the 91 freeway. She abandoned the work truck and now she's trying to wave down somebody for some assistance here. She is a desperate individual who is acting very, very erratic. The wig just fell off. Guys, this is out of control. This is just out of control. This person now running through the front of the Denny's and now into the Denny's. Running into the Denny's. Or Carl's Jr. Is there a Carl's Jr. or a Denny's? It's the Denny's. So there's a Carl's Jr. next door. That person just ran into the Denny's with, I think those may be the original La Habra PD units. I can't tell. They certainly can't all be because at least one of those units was pretty much disabled. And now you can see a number of officers entering the restaurant here, going inside the Denny's to place that person under arrest.
Finalmente el sospechoso salió del restaurante bajo custodia policial y la amenaza terminó.
Here we'll see that suspect walked out of the front of the restaurant, and here she is. There she is. Finally, they've been able to take her into custody. after hiding out inside that restaurant, it appears that she was locked up somewhere in there, and they have finally been able to extract her from this restaurant, now placing her under arrest after what was just a wild and crazy pursuit ending here in Corona.
La señora Greens fue acusada de asalto con un arma mortal contra los agentes, posesión de propiedad robada y evasión. Nadie resultó gravemente herido. En este caso, ¿cómo no se puede decir del siguiente? Aaron Shelton. En el condado de Carroll, Georgia, el 12 de abril de 2021, un oficial de patrulla intentó detener el tráfico en un Nissan Sentra que registró más de 100 millas por hora en la interestatal. Lo que el oficial asumió que era como un caso rutinario de exceso de velocidad rápidamente se volvió mortal. El conductor aceleró con una ventaja razonable sobre el oficial. Fue identificado más tarde como Aaron Shelton y llevaba a un pasajero, su primo Pierre Shelton, de 28 años. Cuando un oficial se detuvo junto al auto, Pierre tuvo una sorpresa, sostenía un rifle de asalto AK-47 y tenía la intención de usarlo. En ese momento, muchos otros agentes fueron llamados para unirse a la persecución. Un sargento recibió un disparo en la cabeza y su coche se estrelló contra la zanja. La situación se había vuelto mortal y no había terminado. Los agentes buscaban lugares estratégicos para poner fin a la situación sin más víctimas. Otro oficial pensó que se encontraba en una posición segura, pero pronto descubrió que estaba equivocado y que estaba bajo fuego pidiendo ayuda. Cuando abandonó su posición frente al coche, el pistolero pasó junto a él. Ese pistolero, Pierre Shelton.
He's on my car, he's on my car.
Aaron Shelton fue acusado de homicidio grave, huir y agredir a un funcionario encargado de hacer cumplir la ley. Fue condenado a cadena perpetua por más de 190 años. Estola de una persona en libertad condicional de 33 años. En el Valle de San Gabriel, el 9 de noviembre de 2022, se envió agentes del orden para localizar un vehículo robado. Ese vehículo sería el primero de muchos, ya que el conductor estaba dispuesto a hacer lo que fuera necesario para escapar de la captura. Veamos cómo se desarrolló el plan.
David, we were up over in Knott's Berry Farm, looked out the window, and what do you have? Another pursuit. This is eastbound 91 freeway, just past the 5 freeway. Unclear which agency is pursuing this vehicle. Right now, he's going so fast, there's nobody right behind him. But very erratic driving, getting off of the 91 freeway. It's a black Honda Civic. He's pulling over and maybe thinking about dumping the vehicle. There goes the driver's side door opening up, and he is either going to walk or run away here. He dropped his phone, and now maybe getting in the vehicle, we'll see here. It looks like he's very, very agitated, in a rush to get away from that vehicle. Getting in a pickup truck, we'll see if he, okay, yeah, he does, I was going to say, maybe he happens, yeah, he's breaking into the pickup truck. For maybe the possibility of the fact that it might be running out of gas. So if the gas is low, and if it's a stolen car, that would have made a lot of sense. Now he's parking it in a parking spot once again. Clearly, really, really trying to get rid of this vehicle, and now running through the subdivision here. We'll try and get across here. It looks like it's going to be North Schooner Lane as he runs through these townhomes. Stay on him right here. He's just running around this building here. Looks like he's coming up on another couple of cars parked here, a van and a small red compact car. Looks like he's trying to break in to the van. He finds an open door in that white van. And now you can see the black and whites pulling up right behind him. He's blocked in. He's inside the car, likely trying to hotwire it at this point. And you can see they have, as he puts it in reverse, he's going up and down, trying to, well, he has nowhere to go here. He's really trying to ram that car out of his way.
Parece que finalmente ha terminado, ¿verdad? No, ni mucho menos. Este ladrón apenas está comenzando.
Not sure if they both came from that same patrol car, but I only see those two officers on foot. And he is just going back and forth. Now he's created some room to escape here, and he's going to probably try and ram in again or do a four-point turn and turn it around. He's got to turn it all the way around without hitting that tree, and he may have a couple minutes to do it here because what else can those officers do? They really don't have many options. Here comes the backup. Here comes backup. Head-to-head. This is dangerous. Yeah, we're in the Norwalk area, I think, now as he comes up. Well, no, he's not in Norwalk yet, but look at this. He's going through that gas station without any tire on that left. Right, that left rear wheel almost struck several vehicles there. I'm in a jam now. Lots of traffic ramming into all of these cars here. Again, this is northbound Carmenita Road now, and it's not moving. He's stuck. Now he's stuck. Probably not aware. Well, now he's aware. I was going to say he might not even be aware that his wheel's on fire, but certainly he's aware of the fire under the hood. More pieces flying out there as this vehicle is starting to come apart. And Fullerton PD, as he gets out of the vehicle, crawls out of the passenger window and is now running for it, northbound Carmenita Road. Running up northbound Carmenita at Leffingwell Road as he crosses the street. We've seen this person make several desperate attempts to hijack other vehicles. We will see. Look at this, a confrontation inside the house, a family home, and now we're gonna come around the front here. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness, look at this. He's in the truck. He's in the truck. He's in the truck. He just got in that truck. There's a dog under that truck. Oh my goodness, look at this. He just stole the, oh my God, oh my goodness. Oh my goodness, this is incredible. This is incredible.
Finalmente, después de más de una hora persiguiendo al sospechoso, el juego se había terminado.
Head on, head on, head on. Unbelievable, head on with another car. And here comes not even a pit maneuver, but they rammed into it from behind, into a gas station, folks getting gas at the corner of Gale and Hacienda, into a gas pump, and now he's gonna try and get out probably, but he's gonna put it out in reverse. Unbelievable, they are using force, deadly force is being employed at this moment to try and stop this madness in the middle. They are stopped. They have stopped. The wheel is off. That front left wheel is off. Yep. Is it still going? Still going. So his foot's on the gas? Unbelievable. Tactical tools at their disposal if they face any resistance. But the first order of business is going to be clearing that driver's side window. The glass breaker is being employed, ramming the driver's side window, and now getting a much clearer view that we will keep somewhat. There is movement. He's moving. He is moving. I saw his hand. The back seat appears clear. Wow. Stepping out of the vehicle. Whoa. Whoa. What in the world? I'm sorry. I'm speechless. I mean, this is just, you know, incredible.
Hasta el momento se desconoce la identidad de este sospechoso y los cargos que se le imputan. Persecuciones policiales con vehículos masivos. La policía estatal de Michigan estaba buscando una mujer que conducía una Windbuggle. Se establecieron varios puestos de control, pero ella logró eludir los primeros intentos de detenerla. La búsqueda comenzó cuando se vio la casa rodante pasando por un semáforo en rojo y el conductor se negó a detenerse ante los oficiales. Al volante estaba Linda Mankel, una mujer con un amplio historial criminal.
So closest lane to you?
A firm. She moved towards me. I was fully marked.
Okay. I'll get him stopped here. Let me light it up. Get up the freeway.
I'm clear.
So bypassing Lake Montcalm, 69 miles an hour.
La persecución a baja velocidad duró 17 minutos y los agentes alcanzaron una velocidad máxima de 85 millas por hora. Aunque conducía sobre pisos llanos, estaba decidida a escapar de la policía.
Come all the way probably from Elm on 46 Redding, driving, passing on the shoulder. They try to get it stopped, wouldn't stop. Try to get some stop sticks on it. Those were successful, and she tried to take out 6466. So
clear. So it sounds like a pursuit on a Winnebago. Anyone in position?
5-7 on the post. Try and get position here.
37, I mean, can't load on follow-up. I can start that way.
She's back westbound on hand, so they're gonna get back to the highway.
Go ahead. It looks like they just flipped around, probably heading back towards 131. 14, which is Canada. So.
14, we're going the wrong way on northbound. Permission to pit.
6-0-6414 southbound in the northbound lanes now.
Speeds at 43, permission to pit.
Southbound in the northbound, speeds at 43. Requesting permission to pit.
El oficial sintió que era hora de hacer algo y presentó un plan de equipo y sintió que era hora de detener el RV.
Southbound speeds at 45.
Still southbound speeds at 45, 1359.
5-3 from 66, just follow her. I'll try and break the traffic up. Cutting across.
Location?
She's still southbound.
Still southbound 131, 1400.
Mientras saltaban chispas del rotor delantero del vehículo recreativo, el oficial vio una oportunidad y la aprovechó. El sospechoso finalmente fue detenido.
KY6 has passed, so Kent County can monitor on the stalker.
I'll call you back.
Kent County says if you need stop sticks, let them know.
Kent County's at 14 mile. I'm at northbound pass. Kent
County's got the freeway shut down at 12 mile.
Get out of the car! 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 Now! Get on the ground! Get on the ground! Hands behind your back! Hands behind your back!
Enough, 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 enough.
Hands behind your back.
Enough.
Now.
Mankell enfrentó 10 cargos, pero 7 de ellos fueron desestimados, a cambio de declararse sin oposición en tercer grado, por huir de un oficial de policía, asalto con un arma peligrosa y destrucción maliciosa de una propiedad policial. Fue sentenciado a un mínimo de 4 años y un máximo de 10. Si se hubiera declarado inocente, habría enfrentado cadena perpetua.